In 2008, Amendment 80 to the Bering Sea and Aleutian Island Fisheries Management Plan was passed. Amendment 80 allowed the non-pollock trawl catcher processor fishery, also known as the Amendment 80 fleet, to transform from a highly competitive and wasteful fishery into a rationalized fishery with individual vessel accountability. Amendment 80 has become a model for the management of sustainable multi-species fisheries. Through cooperative agreement, vessels are assigned quota shares for most target and prohibited species. Since implementation of Amendment 80, the fleet has increased retention of their overall catch from a pre-programmed low of 50% to over 90%, while prohibited species catch has decreased to the point that no PSC cap has been reached. Overall, the result has been an increase in the harvest of target species. While Amendment 80 allowed many of the problems within the fisheries to be resolved, this system of hard quotas combined with a lack of in-season flexibility has created a new set of challenges for the fleet. National Marine Fisheries Service scientists have recently set the combined allowable biological catch limits for the BSAI at more than 2.5 million metric tons. But the current interpretation of optimum yield constrains the National Marine Fisheries Service to set the combined annual total allowable catch at 2 million metric tons. As a result, before the season, NIMS must decide which species are to have their tax set below ABC. When U.S. fishermen first targeted flatfish in the late 1970s, NIMS set the total allowable catch for three flatfish categories. As part of the process, a non-specified reserve of about 300,000 metric tons was used in season to add quota to the tax that were set lower than the fleet's actual catch patterns. The reserve could be used to add quota so long as ABC was not exceeded for any species. Over time, NIMS split flatfish out into seven tax categories, complicating the tax setting process. Harvest estimates now need to be more precise than they were when only three categories were used. Complicating matters as fish species were allocated to specific user groups, they were withdrawn from the reserve program. As a result, the Amendment 80 flatfish species can no longer access the reserve and preseason tax cannot be adjusted later, even if actual catch patterns do not fit preseason estimates. In this multi-species fishery, environmental factors cause catch patterns to vary from year to year. For example, in 2012, sea ice prevented the fleet from accessing its normal spring yellowfin sole fishing grounds. As a result, higher than normal rock sole catch was encountered. To avoid running out of rock sole tack, several vessels tied up for a number of weeks. They returned to the yellowfin sole fisheries in late summer after the sea ice had cleared. This meant harvesting and processing capacity was underutilized, and Amendment 80 quota went unharvested. Some of these quota management challenges can be addressed through inter- and intra-cooperative trades. However, when environmental factors impact the entire fleet, quota trading does not address the real problem, the need for increased tax for some species and reduced tax for other species in this multi-species fishery. Currently, companies must maintain a buffer of quota over expected harvest to avoid reaching their allocation for any tack. If a company fully depletes the quota, the hard cap rules require that company to halt all fishing that may result in any harvest of that species. Since catch composition varies from season to season, fleet members are conservative in their use of quota early in the year. Once catch patterns are known, it may be too late to fully harvest each species. To address all these problems, the flatfish flexibility proposal reestablishes a functioning reserve and provides increased flexibility in this multi-species flatfish fishery while ensuring that the 2 million ton optimum yield is not exceeded and no other user group is impacted. The program essentially allows cooperatives to trade tack with NIMS to deal with variations in annual catch patterns. All quota trades are on a one-to-one basis. Under the flatfish flexibility proposal, pre-season tacks will continue to be set as they are now. However, the system will also allow cooperatives and CDQ groups to access yellowfin sole, flathead sole, and rock sole ABC that is excess of the tack for a species to better respond to changing catch patterns. An ABC surplus will be calculated for each species by subtracting tack from ABC for yellowfin sole, flathead sole, and rock sole. If ABC for each species is 60,000 metric tons, but the individual pre-season tack for those species is set at only 50,000 metric tons, an aggregate tack of 150,000 metric tons is established. Under this proposal, the remaining 10,000 metric ton ABC surplus for each species can be exchanged on a 1-for-1 basis. As an example, in response to in-season conditions on the fishing grounds, co-ops and CDQ groups could exchange 10,000 metric tons of flathead sole for 10,000 metric tons of rock sole or yellowfin sole, or some combination of the two. Since all exchanges are on a 1-for-1 basis, no individual ABC is exceeded, and the total tack remains capped at 150,000 metric tons. The end result is that less quota is stranded. There will be more jobs for fishermen, and the fleet can feed more people all over the world. These quota exchanges will be processed in the same way inter-cooperative transfers are currently handled. The system will allow the Amendment 80 fleet and CDQ groups the in-season flexibility they need to respond to variations in catch patterns and more efficiently harvest their flatfish allocations. This should result in a higher utilization of existing allocations. Under the flatfish flexibility proposal, participants will be able to adapt to changing conditions within the constraints of their total flatfish quota. This will increase the chance that more of the 2 million metric ton optimum yield will be harvested. The program gives Amendment 80 fishermen the opportunity to harvest a greater portion of their allocated quota without adverse impacts on other sectors, a rare win-win situation in fisheries management.